Here we're going to use polynomial long division to divide these binomials. Now you might start the problem like this, but what I'm going to do is give myself some room because I notice there's no x squared term and certainly there's no x term. So if you leave space like that, it's going to be easier to do the long division. In some books, they say sometimes when you're first starting out, maybe you could put in zeros for those missing terms. Either way, let's go ahead and start this. What times x will be x cubed? After a little bit of thought, we can see x squared should do it. X squared times x is x to the third. Distributing x squared times negative 1 is minus x squared. So you could see those like terms lining up. After which you then subtract. Now, x cubed minus x cubed is 0. And when you distribute the negative there, this is really plus. So adding x squared, 0 plus 1x squared is 1x squared. Bring down the next terms, 0x minus 1, and then do it again. What times x would give me x squared? Let's try plus x, that should match it. X times x is x squared. Distributing x times negative 1 is minus 1x. Okay, so here when we subtract, x squared minus x squared is 0. Subtracting a negative is really the same thing as adding. So 0 plus 1x is 1x, and then bring down the minus 1. Okay, and then for the last term, what times x will give me x? Well, that should be easy to see that it's 1. 1 times x is x, and then 1 times negative 1 is minus 1. So here, those are the same. So when I subtract, I certainly get 0, right? X minus x is 0, 1, or negative 1 plus 1 is 0. So this goes in evenly. When I divide these two binomials, the result is x squared plus x plus 1. It went in evenly.